Dominic James has been terrific. Brandon Jenkins is going to have to make sure that they take care of the basketball. Don't give James extra possessions to get those other shooters going for Marquette.
Well, tonight should be fun, and let's get some more info on tonight's game from Robbie Valentine.
Hey guys, a torch will be passed on tonight. Reese Gaines handed it off to Taquan Dean. I asked Taquan about that earlier. He said to me, he will pass it on to T. Will.
Welcome back to Freedom Hall. We get set for the Golden Eagles and the Cardinals. First up, let's go to the Kentucky Lottery's starting lineups. First of all, for the visitors, Steve Novak has played as well as anybody in the Big East this year. He has been terrific. And that backcourt, Dominic James, Gerald McNeil, and then Joe Chapman at a forward spot. He's kind of a combination player. Marquette playing very good basketball. They've won three straight games. Now let's take a look at the Cardinal starting lineup. In the backcourt, Taquan Dean and Brandon Jenkins. Front court, Terrence Williams, Brian Johnson, and Juan Palacios. For Taquan Dean, one more opportunity to thrill the fans here at Freedom Hall. Taquan Dean going to go down as one of the most popular players to have ever played here at the University of Louisville, and hopefully it'll be a great night for him. And even more importantly, Louisville desperately needs a win tonight as they try to get into the Big East Conference tournament. We'll be back with the opening tip, the Golden Eagles and the Cardinals, coming up after these messages. There is Taquan Dean, the lone senior, being recognized by the faithful here at Freedom Hall. Taquan Dean has had a great career on the court. I'm sure, Bob, you'd agree. The personality, the relationships he's developed are the things that will carry forward for many, many years to come.
Well, I was so impressed with the fact that it's, you know, Rick pointed out, his work ethic is second to none. He's first one in the gym. He spends all day there, and yet he's going to graduate on time in 4 years this May. I think that's an indication that this young man has his head on the right way, and he's destined for great things on the court and then wherever his life takes him elsewhere. And it's been a real pleasure to get to know him. He's a terrific young man.
Outstanding young man, and there with him, well, Kevin Owens was in the earlier picture, his guardian, and Talisha, his sister, Azuki, his niece, and Cameron Hampton, his girlfriend, all out at midcourt along with Coach Pitino. And the Cardinal getting ready. It's a huge game for both teams. Marquette-Louisville. Marquette is just a half game out of fourth place. They're thinking about not only going to New York, but having a bye in the first round of the Big East tournament. For Louisville, they feel like if they win tonight, not much else has to happen. If Providence loses tonight and Louisville wins, they're in the Big East Conference tournament. I know there are a lot of scenarios, but that one seems the clearest.
Yeah, well, I was going to say, you know, you want to be in a situation where you control some of your destiny. That guy should be clapping and happy.
Yeah, real happy.
It's going to be awfully tough to pick a coach of the year in this league, but I would think he's got to be on the short list.
Tom Crean in his seventh year at Marquette. We take a look at Rick Pitino. 20th year as a head coach in college basketball. 466 wins, and his team needs another win in order to ensure themselves a place in New York. Our refs tonight, Mike Kitts, Joe Lindsay, and John Higgins. We got 20 minutes on the board, and we're set to play some hoops.
I had a chance to visit with Tom Crean in the pregame, and their priority is going to be really to get to the glass. They know Louisville's had their problems on the backboards, and they've rebounded well away from home. Louisville's going to have to really compete inside.
Brandon Jenkins finds T. Will the three. Dances around, no good. Dominic James with it for the Golden Eagles. Five times this year, he's been the Big East Rookie of the Week. 5'11", 175-pounder from Richmond, Indiana. Novak, one of the best pure shooters in college basketball. Chapman in the post. Bounce pass, and Barrow gets the easy two.
Nice interior pass there.
Palacios has been playing much better basketball of late. Really seems to be healthy for the first time. Jenkins is three. That's off. Fight for the loose ball. It will be Cardinal basketball.
Palacios did well to keep it alive. You make an interesting point because Tom Crean said that. While he has great respect for David Padgett, he said with Johnson now healthy and Palacios getting healthy, he thinks they may be more athletic inside than they've been all year.
Rebound to James. Golden Eagles on the move. And momentarily taken away.
Push.
Chapman's three. Novak fighting for the loose ball, and Jenkins comes away with it. Cardinals on the move. And knocked out of bounds by McNeil.
I don't know how it's going to factor in, but we should tell the people it is extremely warm in here. I mean, and I only bring that up because neither of these teams at the kind of depth they've wanted throughout the year. Marquette's had some injury problems also, so it's a fast pace with so much on the line. We'll see if fatigue is a factor in the second half.
I think they'll know when they come to us on camera at halftime. We're both dripping wet with sweat.
Look like Bruce Pearl? You still haven't seen that picture, have you?
I got to check that out.
Oh, he was a sweaty man.
Jenkins in traffic gets a two. Game tied.
Cards extend the defense a little bit. You got to watch that guy, though. He's had a monster freshman year.
Novak, the triple.
Oh,
got it.
You were in the building. You heard an "oh" go up as soon as he dribbled back. They knew that was coming. They've seen that movie before in this building.
He has made 101 threes just this season. Amazing. 334 in his career.
I think the Louisville fans think he's made 100 in this building.
I think it was amazing. I was looking at his numbers as Dean tries to match.
Plus, he's not got a way to push.
And Williams' three is good. T. Will with the trifecta. Game tied at five. I was looking at Novak's numbers, Bob. 71% of his field goal attempts are from beyond the arc. You don't see that from a 6'10 guy very much.
I don't see that from too many people. Ooh, Rick's not happy with that call.
So James will go to the free throw line to shoot a couple.
Rick now is upset. Not only was it a foul, he's saying he was passing the ball.
James shooting 65% from the free throw line this season.
Tom Crean told me before the games, you're going to look at Rick Pitino, still not happy about that call, that the trip to Alaska, that they won that tournament early in the year, really is the one that showed this team maybe they can overachieve a little bit. That was a big catalyst for their season.
But like you said, I mean, James has been better than advertised, and the advertising was pretty good.
Yeah.
That's an offensive goal to...
Defensive.
Check that, of course. Defensive goal 10.
2 points. Louisville goes on top here. Watch you. We'll see. You see the end of it there. Barrow with his hand through the bottom of the rim. Oh. Great block inside.
Farley with the block. T. Will stop and pop. Got it. Long two. Long two for Terrence Williams.
Well, the officials are unanimous in that. Everybody. Like Winston Churchill going to the press table there. A lot of guys with the V sign there. Indicating 2 point field goal. There's a good atmosphere in here tonight. This would be a terrific win for the Cards. Oh, and a good effective press here. Oh, that was close to a travel.
Novak. Not that time. T. Will with the rebound.
Nice front.
Jenkins is three. Count it.
Nice.
Rattles home. For Brandon Jenkins. A 10-1 run. And the lead is 6. Barrow inside. That blocked by Farley.
This place is rocking like it hasn't for months.
Palacios.
Why not, as you like to say?
A long 2 foot on the line for Juan Palacios. Marquette needs and gets a timeout. Freedom Hall is rocking.
Rick is asking if that last shot was a three or not. Now they're conferring about it. Let's see if they're going to go to the monitor. Oh, we're going to the monitor early, I believe. We're going to the monitor.
Let's have a look. Well, that one, we definitely thought foot was on the line. That was a long two from T. Will.
That was the, Palacios. That one looked like a 3-2. Can we see that again in the truck? Is that, I hate to ask on the air, but I just realized they gave him a 2, and I looked at that. That looked like it, but that wasn't even the one in question. That one by T will look like a 3. And they only gave him a 2. There it is.
Look, Palacios is a 3 for sure.
Palacios is a 3 for
sure. Back.
There it is. He pulls his foot back off the line. That's definitely a 3.
But so far they've only given him 2. It was 12-6.
Well, if they would give him 3, that would make 15.
That's right.
So,
and Billy has made an appearance early.
There's no question. You know what? It's confusing. Sometimes the officials, oh, there we go. The officials have changed their call correctly. The judicious use of our videotape. Kudos to the guys in the truck for getting the shot. And the Cards have a 9-point lead early.
15-6 Cardinals.
My score sheet's a mess because they gave him a 3, then a 2, now a 3. A lot of crossouts on there.
Chapman into the lane, finds McNeil. 16-footer, in and out.
On the run. Kick.
Jenkins got himself caught up in the air.
Good idea, bad execution. That's just the emotion of the moment. They are riding the crest right now. And I'll tell you, there may be something to it, and it's not at all a knock on David Padgett. So before anybody reads into that, it's just a matter of Johnson healthy now, Palacios healthy now, and Farley gets a new chance. He goes out, and he's playing at a level that really heretofore he had never played at. So you got three athletic big guys now, and it's making a heck of a difference.
Now, there's a real silver lining with Padgett being hurt, and these two guys are getting a lot of playing time, and hopefully can build on that and have all those guys healthy and ready to go next season.
Not done with this year yet.
Stay good down. Defense from Jenkins.
Got to stay down. He'll get you up in the air. You'll foul him.
James in traffic, leaves it short. Ball out of bounds to Louisville. We've got our first TV timeout. 15:58 to go in the first half, and Freedom Hall alive and well on senior night as the Cards lead 15-6, playing with great energy right out of the gate. We'll return to Freedom Hall with more basketball as you see Terrence Farley with the block. This game did not get off to a slow start. Instant action is great atmosphere here in the building. This copyrighted telecast is authorized under rights granted to WHAS Television by the University of Louisville Athletic Association. Any use of this telecast without express written permission is prohibited.
Go Louisville! Let's go Cards! Yeah, let's go! Go Cards!
Andre McGee checks in.
Louisville red hot right now. They've hit five of their last six shots. Dean on a drive.
Nice ball movement.
Nice extra pass. McGee short on it. Palacios nice is three. Nope.
That's the experience of Taquan, though. That is something that, as a three-point shooter, he knows that's where you get a lot of wide-open looks off the offensive rebound. He wasn't even on the floor when he was already shoveling that pass to Palacios for a good look. That's a nice play by Taquan. Just couldn't get it to go down.
Wes Matthews, Jr. with the basketball from my hometown of Madison, Wisconsin. We'll talk a little bit about Wes a little later on. Cardinals dominating on the glass. James,
boy,
a lot of contact. Yeah, no foul.
Play in there, boy. That's, you know, this is a reputation in this league for physical play on rebounds, but they usually do protect the shooter and the driver. This is, take a look here. A little contact, but they let it go. And then the foul on the rebound. They've been letting it go both ends, though, consistent. Somebody's open. McGee's double team. One more pass, maybe.
Oh, Palacios leaves it short. Brian Johnson finds McGee. Got it. Andre McGee.
That is already the fourth different Cardinal with a three-point field goal. That's a great omen.
James uses the high screen. They lose the handle. It will remain Marquette basketball.
I'll tell you, I was talking to Billy Burke before the game, the Cardinal assistants, and he said, you know, everybody's aware what's at stake, and there's no secret, but they came out of the West Virginia game thinking, hey, if we play like we did there, you know, if this were January, we wouldn't even be having this discussion about making a Big East tournament. They've finally gotten healthy and gotten on the same page, and they were really pleased with their performance there, even though the result didn't work out perfectly. They are playing better basketball, no question, and healthier basketball.
And the effort has been great all season. These young men have played really hard. Marquette needs to get a timeout. They could not get the basketball inbound. 14:35 to go in the first half. Which brings me to Steve Novak is here tonight. Great shooter. One of the best shooters in all of college basketball. How do you compare him and Kevin Pitsnoggle, who everybody just watched this past weekend? What are their prospects at the next level?
I don't have Pitsnoggle's numbers in front of me, but I'm not sure he shoots the same percentage of threes. But yeah, Pitsnoggle has a more traditional inside game when he chooses to. They're both great shooters with great size.
U of L doing a great job on the offensive glass. Four offensive rebounds. Marquette yet to get an offensive rebound.
I mean, Novak is built more spindly. I'm sorry to interrupt you, but as he came out of the court, you take a look at him. He doesn't look like Pitsnoggle, aside tattoos and baby aside. I mean, there's other differences. Look at that release, though. That one he actually rushed, even for him.
I'm now supposedly, instead of tattoos, it's body art.
Oh, excuse me.
Yes. It's new terminology.
Nice.
Taquan Dean, tough shot, no.
Too bad. So he gets one to go. He might make a bunch. He still hasn't scored yet. But he's got a smile on his face. He is basking in this evening as well he should.
Matthews with the dribble.
Oh, look at Kevin Willard some love. He had that play scouted. He would have gone jump off the bench and defended it. Give the guy credit. He's tall, made a great shot, but they took away the three-point option because they knew that was coming, and again, they're forcing tempo.
Loose ball on the floor. Matthews comes up with it.
Great hustle.
Matthews in traffic, blocking foul, and Matthews will go to the free throw line.
Right play, step late, Miller. Unlike the guy with the ball, you can't, he's a little bit brought to march, you have to give a cutter a time to stop and change direction, and he doesn't here. He doesn't have the ball yet. It's the right play, but he's there a half second late.
Matthews to the free throw line.
That I'm not sure I buy into, though.
6'5", 200-pound freshman.
Holding in the act of shooting. Nice.
He was Mr. Basketball in Wisconsin last year, and he led my former high school to their first ever state championship.
I'll tell you what, if that's the case, then that might not be a block, because if you call him in possession of the ball to take a shot, now you don't have to give him any room. And if Chad's established his position there, that could have been a charge. I thought it was a block because he called him impeding the path of a cutter. And if it was, then they shouldn't have been two free throws. So, strange call there.
Millard didn't take him long. Comes off the bench and launches the triple.
Five now, five different three-point shooters for the Cards. Five of their eight field goals behind the arc.
James does a lot of things well, but three-point shooting is not his strength.
Yeah, that's why you see they're playing in another area code. They're so far off of him. They don't want him to get inside as they go to the zone. Now the Cards.
Matthews in some trouble. Finds Novak. NBA three, in and out.
They look for him again. You got a great three-point shooter. Find him on the rebound.
Matthews three, got it. Wes Matthews. Coach Pitino wants to get 30-second timeout.
You can see when teams have a dominant three-point shooter, they look for him off the offensive glass.
Claire returns to the scene of her kidnapping with hopes of finding a cure for her baby's mysterious illness, and Jack and Locke keep their prisoner a secret from the other survivors. Stay tuned for Lost immediately following tonight's game. Rick giving instructions. Incredible atmosphere tonight here at Freedom Hall. And we'll take a look at the standings in the Big East Conference.
Well, you can see where Marquette, as you pointed out, a half game out of what would be a tie for the fourth spot in a first round bye. That's enormous in the Big East. You don't want to play four games in 4 days. And Louisville, of course, as you see there, a sixth win would be just huge. Give them separation from Notre Dame and DePaul. They have to beat one of those other teams to be sure they're in. Put them in a tie with Rutgers. So, you know, that's the beauty of this league. Is something, and I do agree with the first round bye thing. I really do. I think you play in a league this tough, you finish in the top four, you deserve some reward for that. And plus, it makes it interesting down the end here. Teams trying to just get into the tournament like Louisville. Pretty good team trying to just get there.
I think it's very exciting, the fact that everybody doesn't automatically get to go. Now, if I'm a coach, I'm sure I feel differently. But I think for the fans, it makes it very exciting.
It's very interesting.
Dean guarded by Matthews. That's offensive. Good defense there from Matthews.
Yeah, it was. Taquan tried to take him off the bounce, and Matthews, as you pointed out, didn't bite on any of the fakes, so he was able to get his feet over there and take the charge. Nice defensive play.
Taquan Dean now with two personal fouls, so he needs to be careful.
Cards back to their man-to-man, which actually had started pretty well for them, holding Marquette under 40% shooting.
Matthews from 16 feet, that's way off. Loose ball, Millard's got it.
Nice
Dean
pass.
Ahead of the pack. Oh, and he misses the layup.
Oh, he may be having one of those senioritis nights. He's got to find one to go down.
James tries to drive. Good defense from Jenkins. T. Will and Juan Palacios, along with Brian Johnson, check back in. Dean will get a break.
Jenkins did a great job getting around that screen on Fitzgerald. We didn't let anybody get a piece of him at all. Fought through all those screens and challenged the inbounds pass. Now McNeil's running off screens. Oh, Palacios got hung up. Yep.
That easy two there for Gerald McNeil, the freshman from Chicago.
A lot of standing here again. This is what they weren't doing early. A lot of let the clock get way down and just try and break somebody down off the dribble. That time they did it, but I don't think they're at their best when they do that as a steady diet.
This game got off to just a frenetic pace. Things have slowed down just a bit. 11:26 to go first half. The Louisville lead is now 21-15. Miller, not shy, comes off the bench and drills the three. By 6 points. Let's send it over to our man, Robbie Valentine. Robbie?
Ari, I had a chance to spend some time with Taquan during shoot-around, and it was really interesting. He's real emotional, and we were talking about his senior season, and he said, Robbie, it couldn't be any better. Senior night, he said it won't mean anything if we can't win a big game. He wants to go back home to New York City.
All right, Robbie, that's true. I mean, for Taquan, how special it'd be to get a chance to go to Madison Square Garden, play some basketball, and win some games.
And aside from that, we've made this point on the radio show and elsewhere. It's a very unique experience. I know it's redundant. It is the Big East tournament. You need to get your new players a chance to play in that. You don't want to waste a year's opportunity. They want to get there this year.
McNeil.
Card's fourth turnover. Marquette has not made a turnover. Oh, that could have been one. Oh, boy, that looked like a travel.
McNeil spin. There it is. That's a travel. Taquan Dean will check back into the game.
I've got to stop because the officials watch these tapes, and I don't want them to think I'm second-guessing everything they're doing. They look great.
They're well-dressed. I mean, their outfits are very coordinated.
It's been a very physical game. The Big East is known as a physical league. There's been some contact, but there was possibly a travel. They got that one there, though, so certainly don't be mad at me, officials. I'm just not second-guessing, just observing.
Brian Johnson.
Nice defense by James.
That's off to Nate.
Force the turnover.
Steve Novak back into the game for the Golden Eagles.
Ooh, Rick yelled two and then changed to five. He was going to go zone and decided to go man.
There are the turnovers thus far.
Yeah, we told you they had that traveling violation on the last possession for Marquette. Their first turnover. And again, something I listened to Tom Crean's pregame comments. He thinks that's been a key for this successful run late here, as they've taken care of the basketball. All coaches say that, but he thinks particularly important.
Novak, the fadeaway is good. Steve Novak.
And the problem is there was a lot of emotion early. Now you got to kind of punch the clock, get to work. You can't ride on those fumes anymore. Now it's time to move and start doing things. Get a little stagnant here. There's a good screen.
Yep. T. Will's jumper, too strong.
Oh, Johnson kept it alive.
T. Will. Beautiful arc on his shot, but could not get it to fall.
Got to get back. They are ready to go, Marquette.
McNeil. And he gets that shot. You know, this team reminds me a little bit of Villanova in the sense that they got all different kind of guys who like to drive, and then they kick it out for the three. They have some similarities. I watched the Villanova-Marquette game. It was very entertaining.
Yeah, it is. Their offensive philosophies are based on great spacing, find seams, drive the basketball in, look for open men, whether they're interior passing or kick out to shooters. You're right. In that regard, they are similar.
Barbara Walters talks with George Clooney, Patrick Dempsey, Matthew McConaughey, and Maria Carey for the 25th annual Oscar edition of the Barbara Walters special, right after Lost, here on WHAS 11.
Right, let's see, the momentum has clearly turned around. 13-3, Marquette was shooting down around 30%. They're up at 41% now. Louisville, which had that stretch where they made 5 of 6 shots, has gone cold again. They are now at 42%. So, but you know, that is also when you have teams of similar styles. Louisville's not quite as much drive and kick as Marquette, but they were making a lot of threes early. You're going to get a game of runs. Louisville now has got to put a run together of their own to get some of that momentum back.
The lead is only 2 points. See who will step up here. Jenkins in traffic. Tough shot, no good. Good hustle, though. He tracks down the loose ball.
Rebound 16-7, Louisville. dominating the glass early.
They haven't done that to many people in this league.
Foul on Grimm. That's just the third team foul. Marquette, one of only two teams this year to beat UConn. And I know you really think UConn is perhaps the team to beat in the NCAA tournament.
Well, it's a short list of five, and they're on it. If the national champion doesn't come from one of five teams, I'll be very surprised, to be honest with you. And they're one of them.
So I could take the field against you besides those five?
Yeah, right now, and I never make that bet. This year, I think I'd do it. That's how much of a gap I see between those five and everybody else.
We'll discuss it at Bocce Ball tomorrow.
Oh, beautiful. Nice kick. Good look for Taquan.
Dean's three. Count it.
That's Jenkins' play there, though. Beautiful penetration and the dish.
Fitzgerald finds McNeil. Now he missed the layup. As that shot blocked, and Jenkins is fouled by Fitzgerald.
Yeah, that's going to get the crowd into it because that was a physical foul in a non-traditional place. I mean, you get bodies banging under the basket. People understand that. That was kind of in the open field there, chasing the ball to the corner, and he put a pretty good lick on Taquan, but Taquan seems no worse for the wear. He's ready to go. He just made a three. He wants to get that ball back in bounds and go again.
This place is buzzing tonight. There's a great atmosphere at Freedom Hall.
Hey, take a look here again. Really, he's going for the ball. It's just a hard fall. And it wasn't even Taquan. I misspoke. It was, from my angle, I couldn't see. It was Brandon Jenkins.
Jenkins, the three. Not this time. Rebound to McNeil.
Farley, though, active, trying to go to the glass.
Been a long rest here for Dominic James, their outstanding freshman point guard. Matthews has been running the point. A little bit of confusion here. I think the official thought that Green wanted a timeout.
Yeah, I do too. Well, now he's going to get one because we're under 8 minutes.
That worked out pretty well. The both teams will head to their respective benches. That's on the single wireless airtime shootout. 7:49 to go in the first half. The Louisville lead is 5 points. Great atmosphere. And here, Dean, his first triple of the night. 4-19. Now, let's take a look at the resume for Marquette. We already mentioned that win against UConn. That's clearly their best win, but they've had a terrific season. No, not that they're in, but I mean, even better than getting in. Where do you think they might be seated?
That depends on where they wind up in the Big East tournament. That, you know, you can play yourself up or down a couple of lines by the Big East tournament. So
starts
really,
today. You're on the selection committee.
I can't even answer it because I'd have to go through the field, honestly. You know, it's not the answer you wanted, but only what I can give you. Because right now, there's a lot of teams you have to really take a good, hard look at.
Been a fun year for college basketball. James, wild three as the shot clock expires.
Oh, they got it back.
Yeah, no back. Now he misses the jumper.
Oh, Millard gets a big step-in rebound. That was dodging a bullet for both teams. Looked like there was going to be a shot clock violation. Then they wound up getting a good shot by Novak. But Louisville not hurt by it with the second rebound, as we see. Dominating the glass, something they haven't been able to do very much this year.
Farley and Johnson have only combined for two rebounds, so everybody's hitting the glass.
He's doing everything. Six different three-point shooters. It's been a real team effort here.
Jenkins in traffic with the left hand. Pretty move by Brandon Jenkins.
He's got seven. And in other words, we've talked about game of runs. Louisville's turn to put a little run together now. The lead is cut down to two. They've extended it back to seven. They've had some wild games, these two teams. Some from nail biters that hardly any separation for 40 minutes to a 40-point win here a couple of years ago, Louisville over Marquette. It's been everything in between.
McNeil, he lost the handle. T. Will. Hangs in the air, tough shot, it's good. Soft touch there from T. Will.
He's obviously a very, very gifted athlete. See how easily he runs and hangs in the air. Very, very gifted. A little experience, going to get even better.
The fans wanted a travel.
That one I don't think was. He kept his foot down. That was a good call.
Chapman, three in and out. Novick cleans it up. Steve Novak in the right place at the right time.
He's got nine, and Jenkins is hurt. Jenkins' right wrist. Right there at the bottom of your screen. And I'm not sure what he did. We'll see if we can find it. But he is, and the bad news is it's his shooting wrist. He's holding his. If that's a significant injury with everything else that's gone on this year, it literally would be unbelievable. They finally hitting their stride here, overcome some things, trying to play their way into the Big East tournament. And I don't know what he did, but he is hurt.
And he's a tough guy, only one of two players who started in every game this year, him and Juan Palacios. As this team has just had some bad luck, lots of injuries. You can tell Jenkins in some pain. Dean used that high screen, open for the triple. Novak with the rebound.
Hates what he does to get you up in the air. Fortunately for T-Will, though, didn't foul him.
James.
Nice job by T-Will staying home. Good work by Terrence Williams. Not going sinking down to the cutter, knowing that they were going to look for the kick out to Novak. He took that option away.
Shot clock down to six.
Uh-oh, they switched, yeah, and they got McGee holding Novak.
All that defense, and then they commit the foul with just 5 seconds on the shot clock.
Well, that's a, McGee knows they've switched, and it's late in the shot clock. He's going to do everything he can to keep Novak from getting the ball. He got a fistful of his jersey.
Good news here.
I wonder if a finger popped out or something, and they popped it back in. That happens sometimes because he was in great pain. He's still flexing that right hand. It was thumb, but he looks like he's ready to go. It's obviously his right thumb. When he came back on the court, you could see that's what he was tinkering with.
Less than 5 minutes to go, first half. Cards came out on fire. At one point, they led 18-6.
Novak will shoot it right where he is.
James, the three, no. Good rebound from Brian Johnson. Palacios.
Boy, they are firing down the floor, though. They are really, they bought into this. They're going to push it at every opportunity. They obviously have worked very hard on that in practice.
Chapman bounces it off his leg. The Cardinal basketball.
Third turnover now for Marquette. Not that many in the game either way, really. Louisville's only got five, but the advantage on the boards for Louisville still 19-13. Jenkins heads back to the bench. Doesn't seem to be in too much pain, though, right now.
We've gotten word that it may be a sprained thumb, and Bob was all over the thumb injury. Dean's three. That was an NBA three. No good. Fitzgerald has it for Marquette.
Ooh, McGee's got, they got a mismatch. Novak on McGee.
James has been quiet in the first half. Only 1 point so far.
Novak wants him to go this way so he can, I guess, come off a screen.
Matthews on the drive. Shot no good. Grimm and Johnson both had a hand on it.
Shot clock, though. They didn't hit the rim. They got to go. This is going up.
Novak. Fadeaway three. No. T-Will's got McGee for the triple. Why not?
Nice kick by Terrence.
The lead is up to 10. Fans up out of their seats here at Freedom Hall. Cardinals on a 10-2 run. James, the jumper. That almost went in off the glass.
That's the shot they wanted to take, though. They are guarding the wings and pretty much daring him to shoot it from the top, because as you pointed out, it's not his forte at all. James, just a 31% three-point shooter.
Fitzgerald on the drive.
Novak.
Offensive foul.
Great play by Brian Johnson. That's good defense. This crowd is trying to physically pick the cards and Freedom Hall up and deliver it to New York. And so far, they're halfway there.
Amazing atmosphere. Fans loving it here. Giving great support to the Cardinals. They lead the Golden Eagles by 10 points. We'll be back with more basketball to Freedom Hall. 21. You know something we've been doing all year? We got to know the foe. I know everybody knows it from Conference USA, but this is Marquette, the Big East version.
Yeah, famous alums. You get a look at Chris Farley and Ralph Metcalf and Dwayne Wade, Doc Rivers. But maybe the most identifiable name with Marquette basketball will remain Al McGuire, the legendary coach and Hall of Famer, the late Al McGuire, who was led them to a national championship. Very colorful character. Also, by the way, Kyle Motes, who's our regular guest on our radio show Wednesdays, the national director of marketing for Louisville, was the same capacity at Marquette for a while before he joined the Cards. So
let me ask you in a politically correct way. Okay. How many years did it take you to get over Marquette changing their name from Warriors? Because I remember that 77 team. They were the Warriors.
Don't open that can of worms with the alums there. We may get phone calls tonight on that. Still a sore item with a lot of folks.
Oh, they had those great uniforms, and they were the Warriors.
Well, this is like their third nickname this year, right? Didn't they go to... They got rid of this for a while, I thought.
McGee on lunch. Rebound to McNeil.
He's the only one with the two threes for Louisville. They've had six different three-point shooters. He's the only one with a couple. Oh, and here we go.
Got numbers. Four on two. T. Will finds Palacios.
Bad spacing there, though. There were too many guys too cluttered together there. That should have either been a layup or a wide open three, not a fallback mid-range shot. They didn't get the good spacing in transition there. He's doing a real good job of staying down when he gives that up fake on Novak. It may seem quiet, but he still has 9 points already, Novak.
Now, I just looked at that and was wondering how many points he had. Very quiet 9 points for Novak.
Cards defense has been terrific for most of this first half.
Shot clock at two. And Matthews is fouled underneath. So I got a little story for you about Wes Matthews.
Okay.
Do you remember his father, Wes Matthews Sr.,
at
Wisconsin, played?
Sure.
So we take a look at the lead play, replay. So one of my best friends growing up, Corey Moore, his older sister, Pam.
Well, that's a tough call. He jumped back, but he's really in that position.
She played at Wisconsin, met Wes Matthews. They had a child together, Wes Jr. And I can remember as a kid thinking, wow, you know, things pan out. This guy would be an incredible athlete. What a gene pool. Ends up being Mr. Wisconsin in basketball. And here he is, a freshman playing for Marquette.
Well, and Tom Crean said before the game that, you know, for all the credit that James is getting as a freshman, Matthews had been starting most of the season until he got hurt. And now coming off the bench, he's given them a big lift. So he's another reason they're overachieving in some people's eyes.
Now, he's a great young man, good student. He was a great soccer player as well in high school. 31-22.
Taquan back in the game with 1 3-pointer to his credit on the night and senior night here. Well, somebody's open. There he is right there.
Dean's three. Nope, Miller. Instead it's James.
He's not going to get a more open look than that.
Tough shot. Boy, James, acrobatic layup for Dominique James.
Boy, and look at the Cards run it right back. They have really embraced this forced tempo every opportunity. Driving kick, somebody's free, and there he is. One more, maybe.
A deep three, and that one's short. And Marquette making a mini run here. Final moments of the first half. Matthews in and out.
Oh, look at Andre fighting for it.
Good ball try. Out of bounds to Marquette.
Louisville's margin on the glass has disappeared. It's 20 all.
Second differential, game clock to shot clock.
Yeah, Tom Crean wants him to back it out and run this thing down, leave Louisville 4 seconds or so. So not really get a good opportunity at a last shot. Unlike the end of the game, if they score, the clock doesn't stop in the last minute, so. So if you shoot really late, Louisville unlikely to get a last shot opportunity. And Jenkins is draped over Novak like a cheap suit. He is just chasing him every step he takes.
Shot clock down two. I didn't get that off. That shouldn't count. They're going to score.
Oh, no, and Millen almost threw it away and gave another one.
Wow, that was really close. I'd love to have another look at that. They played 20 minutes here at Freedom Hall. Louisville leads Marquette 31-26. Good news, Louisville fans. Louisville is 15-4 when leading at the half. Try to take a look at a replay.
This is McNeil for his third field goal. Let's take a look. Watch the light.
See the shot clock.
See the light. The scoreboard will go on. Oh, you couldn't really see the light.
Yeah.
Couldn't really see it in that, unfortunately. Because they really do go by the light on the board. Tough to tell there. Very close.
Very close. It's a 5-point game at the half. Stick around. The halftime report is coming up.
Are you both crazy?
The last play before the half, the light does not go on when the shot clock expires, only the time clock for the half. So
does that change your opinion? I thought the shot was late. What do you think?
So, well, now I would have had to watch again and just try and hear the horn is the last thing they use, but I would have watched the shot clock more closely, and I didn't. So as you watch the shot clock, are you still convinced it was after the prescribed time?
I thought it was late. It was at a full zero, and there was a pause before it left his hand.
Okay, well, then it would be.
If it ends up being a 2-point game, we'll revisit that, and maybe it'll be a 9 issue.
Well, maybe. Remains to be seen. Louisville's defense was outstanding in the first half. They opened in zone here.
McNeil, the three. Not much arc on that one. Rebound to T. Will.
Got to get those long rebounds when you guys are taking the long shots, especially flat like that one. Good job by T. Will reacting to the ball.
Yeah, T. Will's got six rebounds already.
One of the advantages when you push the ball like this is, look, they're in their half-court set at 25 on the shot clock. Gives you time to make a lot of passes, move a lot of people, knock Novak down if you want to.
Brandon Jenkins, that's got to be offensive. You know, a little bit out of control.
He's done a good job of getting inside. You know, you don't have a traditional post-up game. Your presence around the basket has to come from drives, slashes, cuts. And so Jenkins has been probably better at doing that than anybody tonight. And he tried to maybe force that one a little bit. But you do have to get in that lane. You know, it doesn't have to be a 6'10 guy posted in there. Somebody's just got to get in the lane, make him respect you attacking the basket like they did right there.
Yeah, McNeil, that's an easy two off the dish from Dominique James. Dean, NBA three, rattles home for Taquan Dean.
His second three of the ball game. And we all know if he makes one, he's liable to make a bunch.
James, that's a tough shot. Rebound to Brian Johnson.
Johnson challenged it, did a good job.
Brandon Jenkins, that's a tough shot and gets it to go.
Decided to take Novak to the butter, and here we go the other way.
James, let the track meet begin.
I'll just be here if you need me.
36-30 cards.
They're keeping you busy. Look, the shot clock's only at 28 now. They've already in their set, starting their offense. Oh, nice dish.
No look pass. Palacios can't finish. He was bumped from behind.
Mumbaro with the push from the back. Good job by Palacios. Great pass by Taquan. See what they get out of this baseline out of bounds here.
Jenkins, an open look. James with the rebound.
Marquette, same philosophy. Look at this. They're already in their set here. 29 on the shot clock. So these teams are very similar in lots of traits.
James is the catalyst for the offense. This is McNeil. That is swatted by Terrence Farley. He's got four block shots already.
Oh, that's great ball movement.
Palacios, the triple is good, and a foul.
That is terrific ball movement there. You know, this is a sophisticated basketball crowd. They like to win, but at the bottom of it all is they appreciate good basketball, and they know when the game's being played the way it's supposed to. That was great spacing, great transition. Watch the ball movement. T. Will doesn't force, doesn't take a charge in the lane, quick pass. Much, the ball can easily move much more quickly than the defense, and they wind up with a wide open three.
A foul on Barrows, his third. Cardinals lead by nine. We'll be back. Lead the Golden Eagles 39-30. Lost. Claire returns to the scene of her kidnapping with hopes of finding a cure for her baby's mysterious illness. And Jack and Locke keep their prisoner a secret from the other survivors. Stay tuned for Lost. Immediately following tonight's game, you will see Lost in its entirety. You will not miss 1 second. We could go to quadruple overtime. And
so what you're saying is they're going to show the entire program after the game.
No matter what.
That's pretty impressive.
It is. They've got that kind of control at WHAS. They'll say, we'll start at 9 o'clock, maybe 9:03.
Whenever we feel like starting the darn thing, we're going to start it.
And you know people will be watching.
Yes, gets very good ratings.
Yes, the number one show on ABC. By the way, I'd like to give props. The Ladybirds on senior night,
they
outstanding.
Were, that number was mesmerizing. They were working it there. That was a big-time production number. I believe in gymnastics terms, they'd say they nailed it.
They didn't nail it. With the new scoring system in figure skating, I couldn't come up with a score, though, there. McNeil, the easy two.
He's getting inside. He's their inside presence. And here we go back the other way.
The three from T. Will. Too much on that one. Keep an eye on McNeil. As Bob said, he's been the guy who's really gotten him going here in the second half.
Jenkins working very hard to keep Novak from getting free for a three. Holds him. It says that's only his second foul. It's really not a bad foul because you don't want to let that guy get going. Louisville's biggest statistical advantage in the game has been behind the three-point line, without question. That's the single thing that's got them in the lead. Well, that's five there. Yeah. Yes, sir.
You know, they've really struggled all night getting the ball in from the baseline.
Oh, that's great scouting. Remember Rick was talking early in the year about one of the things that's hard to do with a young team. That's what he's talking about. The way they perceive and interpret the scouting report, and that's one of the ways you see it on baseline out of bounds plays. How hard do you make it for them to get it in? Can you get a turnover on it? That's preparation and execution.
Dean three off the back iron. James gets behind the defense and he's fouled while he's up in the air.
So one of the things I think is upsetting Rick, I mean, he doesn't want to see them make layups, but he likes the fact they've made nine threes, Louisville, and the opponent's only made two. And so you know it's somewhere in there you're going to give up a layup on occasion. That's the trade-off you make. And here's a James turning the corner. They bailed him out, though, a bit there because I don't think he would have been able to get a good enough angle to get it to the other side of the rim.
Misses the first one. Just a 65% free throw shooter as McGee comes in for the Cardinals and Matthews for the Golden Eagles. I learned at the half that Wes Matthews Sr., who we discussed in the first half, is in the house behind the Marquette bench. 9 years in the NBA. I believe he won a ring with the Lakers. I'm not entirely sure of that, but I believe he did. With Magic and Kareem.
Oh, that's a bad opportunity loss for Louisville.
Oh!
Another block by Farley. Is that five now?
Five blocks.
Wow. But he's really doing a terrific job. That's just what you want. You can jump second and still block shots if you're a good shot blocker. And when you do that, you avoid fouling.
Channing Farley and Freedom Hall. That's out of bounds. Be Cardinal basketball.
Can he just shoot that behind the basket? That's not a good shot.
Tough to shoot a high percentage from behind the board.
Generally, you got to be on the right side.
Travel. Jenkins, yep.
The stats, other than blocks, are so even. Except for three-point field goals. That's why I keep hammering that point. It's been a big advantage, and Louisville's got to commit to just making sure they are out on every shooter, man or zone. And they've done a great job of it so far.
Coming into tonight, Marquette on the season had made 14 more threes than Louisville. As you take a look at the three-point shooting, just dominated by the Cardinals thus far.
Cards are hoisting them up, too, 24. Oops, that's not the guy you want to let get free.
You might have to take the heat for that one. Novak hits the triple.
I've said it about five times, so I refuse to be held accountable for that.
Dean tries the match. No good.
Miller.
Oh, good job inside from Chad Miller.
Oh, that was a real opportunity. I don't think Matthews saw Miller, but he did a good job athletically getting around him.
McNeil, that block by Miller. Dean.
Boy, short. Just can't get it going.
Went for the ball, knocked out of bounds by Taquan Dean. We will take a break when we come back. It'll be Marquette basketball. Been an incredible atmosphere here tonight at Freedom Hall on senior night. Taquan Dean didn't get it, but there is Miller to clean it up. The Card lead is 7 points. 10 seconds to go in the second half. In the Big East, Notre Dame leading Providence. If Notre Dame wins and Louisville wins today, no more complicated math, no more scenarios. Louisville will go to Madison Square Garden.
It would be New York bound for the Cards. UConn was ahead in that game 18-0. So I don't think they're really being particularly threatened.
And Louisville fans are rooting for Villanova to beat St. John's. And there you see Kentucky. They've just gotten started against Tennessee. Florida State trying to knock off number one Duke.
That's the short list in my mind, those five teams. I said that.
Villanova, UConn, Duke.
Memphis.
And who's number five?
Actually, I have to modify. Nice drive. Oh! That's
a goaltend.
Yeah, but that's a great job by Farley trying to get up there and get a piece of that. Early in the year, had put Texas on that list, took them off, then had Florida on the list and took them off. So I really have to reserve judgment. I have to say four for sure, and I'm going to find a fifth because Gonzaga might be on them. I haven't seen them in person yet. But I think those four are pretty much ahead of everybody else by a significant margin, to be honest with you.
I just think it's hard for me to judge Memphis only because while they played a great non-conference schedule, it had been so long since they've played any of the other great teams. I don't know how that affects you. It could work for you, could work against Memphis.
They looked so good in the Garden early when I saw them in the preseason NIT. I just don't think you lose that. I do think maybe their conference makes it hard. What's the call here?
I think there's going to be a hold on McGee as he was trying to track Wes Matthews.
Yeah, and a fistful of jersey. They don't like when you do that. You're right, it may only be four. I mean, Gonzaga, I don't know, same deal. You know, their league, you wonder. And I've not seen them in person. I really do believe you need to see people in person. To get a real feel for how strong they are. And I think it's a perfect example tonight, Ari. You watch this Louisville team right from the opening tap. That West Virginia game, even though they lost, gave them a great deal of confidence. They feel like they've worked around some of their problems, their shortcomings in terms of personnel. Their inside guys are healthy. They're really comfortable forcing tempo. Their defense has been good.
Well, they have recreated themselves.
Yeah, they really have.
Matthews, that is blocked. That was
like a deli. Take a number for who's going to block it. Palacio said, I want it. Farley said, I got it. There were four hands ready to smack that out of there. Now, here's what we talked about earlier. Watch the scouting report on the baseline out of bounds plays.
Novak and McNeil are 10 for 22. The rest of the team is just 5 for 20.
Nice job by McGee. They had him isolated on the opposite side with James. That was supposed to be a quick hit for him to lay up. Did a good job taking that away from him.
That was a shot clock triple for Dominique James. He doesn't hit many from out there.
And now we're back to two. This game of runs continues. Each team has made two runs of some substance, and now we are almost even.
Dean, the three. No. And that's going to be a foul against Juan Palacios.
Your heart goes out for Taquan, who's having one of those emotionally charged, distracted nights. He is now just 2 of 13. Second half cards struggling behind the three-point line, which, as we said, is where they had the big advantage in the first half. But as Taquan says, I always believe the next one's going in, so I don't expect him to get gun-shy.
Marquette on a 9-2 run over the last 3 minutes and 45 seconds.
It's been, as we said, two runs. Cards made one early. Oh, alley-oop, wide open.
Oh, Wes Matthews throws it down. Beautiful pass from James. This game is tied at 42.
That was a good time to run that. It ties the game, and that's one of those baskets that's worth more than the 2 points because it gives your team an emotional charge. Louisville's got to find an answer, get a good look here.
They like that play. They ran that same play to perfection against Villanova. A few weeks back in Philly. Dean's three.
Way off. I mean, they're flat. He's not getting any lift. Not following through. He's going to shoot it again, though.
This time he's going to take it inside. Can't finish fighting. I'm not sure who finally knocked that in.
I think he did based on his yell after the play. I think that was a third effort. Forget about a second effort. I think that was a third effort for Dean. And that got the crowd emotionally charged because this crowd wants to will the ball in the basket for that young man, as popular as he is. Sean Roth introduced him before the game as one of the most popular Cardinals in the history of the program, and I don't think that's an exaggeration. He's just an admirable, lovable kid who's given his all.
I've only been here for a year. The guy's got a magical smile. Three, no good. Fitzgerald knocked it away from his teammate. Cards on the move. Two on one. Dean, that's blocked by James, but a foul. And Dean, when we come back from a break, we'll go to the free throw line to shoot two.
Hey, it's a close game between Louisville and Marquette. What do you know? How many of those have we seen over the last few years?
Taquan Dean just battling. Outside shot's not working. So just keep working. Finally gets the two. 42. Let's send it over to Robbie Valentine. Robbie.
Hey, guys. One of the things that's going on in this arena is a lot of energy. Freedom Hall is pumped up. I don't think I've ever seen this crowd stand up as long and cheer for a group of young men in my life. They're going to need that down the stretch.
That is true. And, you know, Bob, you've talked about it, how this crowd is seemingly trying to will them to New York tonight.
Well, they understand, as I said, this is a sophisticated basketball crowd. They get it, and they know what's on the line. and they also know how much this young man has given to this program. He's played through hernias and pulled muscles and everything in between, and he's made some of the most dramatic shots over the last couple of years, and he's done it all with a smile on his face. He's going to graduate in May. I think they want to see him get a chance to go finish his career in the Big East tournament, where I think correctly they think he belongs. Quietly putting some points on the board now. He's got 10 on the ball game. Gets, climbs into double figures.
Yeah, he leads the way so far for the Cardinals. The only player in double figures.
And maybe the Cards now trying to put a run together. As we said, two runs apiece right now. We'll see who makes the third one. Oops, they bit on the fake.
Novak, the pure jumper from the baseline.
Marquette in its own here now. Let's see if they, that's what you wanted, high post. Yep, that opens things up.
Miller, three, no. But good execution. James is the floor general.
Yeah, this is, now they're getting some movement. Novak trying to come off a screen, then set a screen.
Novak, the three and the foul for Steve Novak. Guy's unbelievable.
Well, they done a good job staying home on him all night. That time you come off him an inch, then you realize, uh-oh, came in too far. And then you overreact to recover. You run at him and hit him. This could be our second four-point play of the evening. Palacios had one earlier.
Steve Novak in some special company. He now has, within Big East Conference play, 63 made threes. And that ties one of the great shooters in Big East history, Ray Allen, for most threes in a season.
That was a big rebound. If they'd come up with that, Marquette, and then able to score again, could have gone up three or four and really had a momentum swing. Louisville gets the deflected rebound. Now they got to get in their set without Taquan, who's gone to the bench.
Jenkins, good look. Doesn't go. That James, a terrific defensive rebounder.
They're getting good looks. They got to hang in there. Don't give him that one. Ooh, the Cards dodging a major bullet there. And here they go. He should run right around him. Yep.
Tough shot. No good. Goes and gets it. T-Will.
He had the full head of steam up and that great athletic ability. Get in the lane. I'm not sure the first shot was a good one, but he did a great job staying with it and turned it into an easy second shot. Again, this crowd on its feet trying to will the Cards to New York.
48-47. Matthews into the lane, floater, no good, follow, no good. Palacios will bring it up himself, and he is fouled by Matthews. That's just the fourth team foul against Marquette.
Not an easy game to officiate. Lots of perimeter emphasis, and actually in a lot of ways that's more difficult to call because you got guys coming off screens, curling off screens, guys grabbing a handful of jerseys, sticking an elbow in, banging, bumping, and if you don't call those things, you penalize jump shooters.
Dean's three.
Boy, he's just way off, though. I mean, not only are they not going in there, when you're missing right and left, that's a bad sign. If you miss short or long, that's okay, but right or left is a sign you don't have your AI.
Fitzgerald will penetrate. Tough shot, no good.
Taquan needs to get a run out and try and get an easy one in transition.
Ball knocked away. 9:07 to go in the second half.
It is another one of the things that comes with the territory in the Big East. This is the atmosphere in here I haven't seen in a regular season game for a long time. Maybe translated in that shooting for the Cardinals. Maybe they're just pressing a little bit now, but frankly, in Conference USA, there was not this kind of a game frequently in the regular season. There's so much on the line. Marquette playing for a bye. Louisville playing to get to New York. One of the great basketball parties in the country goes on in New York. They want to be part of it.
Lob inside. Farley basket on the foul. Terrence Farley.
Nice delivery by Taquan. And a nice job by Farley, who's come so far just in the last 2 months.
This crowd has taken to him. I mean, he was, as everybody remembers, a couple of days from being out of the program completely. Six blocks tonight. And a three-point play, and looks good on the release of the free throw. A great story of progress and becoming an important part of the team down the stretch here.
Pressure from the Cardinals. When I saw we had this game on the schedule, Bob, I was hoping it'd be a great atmosphere, but this has blown me away. This crowd has been into it since before the game even started, right from the presentation to Taquan Dean.
They're trying to get Novak, who sets the screen on the dribbler. If you watch it, they've been doing that a couple of times now. He sets the screen on the dribbler, and then they pick for him. So the dribbler, for example, goes off his screen to the left. Then they come and set a back screen on Novak going back to the right, and they look for him there. And Cards are playing it very aggressively, switching it a lot, but there's going to be a turnover. They tried to get him off the screen again. Aaron Pass.
Chad Miller will come back into the game, and Palacios will go to the bench.
Well, we talk about runs. Cards were down 47-46. They put five in a row on the board. Now maybe they're putting a run together. We'll see.
U of L has been launching from beyond the arc tonight. They've already attempted 32 threes. There's a foul on McNeil.
Holding, trying to get over that screen, and we'll get a timeout.
Everyone can catch their breath. Still 7:59 to go in this one. Cards lead by four, and they are battling and fighting to try to get a trip to New York City and the Big East Conference Tournament. We'll be back to Freedom Hall. We're back. The lead is 4 points, and it's time now for the fourth drive of the game.
T-Will so explosive right there. You can see he's going to be able to outrun Novak. Then it does a good job avoiding the charge. Doesn't get a great shot, but stays right with it. Basically just used the first shot as a pass to himself and gets the easy follow. Nice finish by T-Will. He's got nine on the evening.
Pardon me, Bob. We keep talking about what a great team effort. Seven of the eight players who've been on the floor have scored, and only one of them in double figures with 10, and two other guys with 9 points. So everybody has been a part of the game tonight. And
six different three-point shooters as well. And that guy's not had his best shooting night, but he's got a couple, and he does have 10 points.
McNeil with the steal. Up to Novak. He's got company.
Oh, great job by T-Will. Coming from the back. Got to secure the loose ball. Great play.
Dean will go baseline. He is bumped.
And that's going to put him in the bonus. That's a great job by Taquan. You're not having your best perimeter shooting night. He is, after all, just 2 of 13 behind the arc. Take it to the rack, see if you can get to the line. Well, got a little run working here. Cards are five-point run and counting here. It was 47-46 at one point.
First one rattles home for Dean.
I wonder how many practice shots he's taken in his 4 years here. I'd love to know that number.
I would suggest normally you need a calculator, but you might need a full-blown computer for that.
Your abacus will blow one of the little beads.
Yeah. I'm just jealous I wasn't here for more of it. True pleasure to watch. He hits them both. The lead is 6. T-Will thought it might have deflected off Chapman.
Complains, then says, good call. I love when guys do that. Like, whoops, I don't want to overplay my hand here. I am a freshman, after all. Nice call. Rebounds 34-31. Louisville's taking a little edge there again.
Palacios checks back in, and Miller goes to the bench.
Actually, the latest stats, it's 35-34. So, again, it's even almost everywhere, except the great 6 blocks by Louisville and their great 3-point shooting.
Novak's 3. No good, and Dean with the rebound.
Great 3-point shooting advantage, not necessarily percentage. They're just making more in volume. Maybe another one.
T-Will's 3. Rainbow, no good. Palacios.
Kick it out. You got Taquan. One more guy.
Jenkins will try it. Why not? Brandon Jenkins.
That's what last year's team did better than most teams in the country. Ellis Miles got an offensive rebound. You were open, he found you. This team is starting to get the hang of doing that. That's a great weapon. And the fifth run of the game goes to Louisville, and they're back up nine.
McNeil drives, spin, tough shot, no good. Farrell there to clean it up. First field goal for Marquette in the last 4.5 minutes.
As I said, the fifth round went to Louisville. Let's see if there's a sixth.
T. Will, finger roll, no good. Farley had it, lost it. Here come the Golden Eagles.
Well, don't give him that lane. He'll make you pay. And that's not a travel. You got to have possession to travel.
Be fun to just if we had a split screen of Tom Crean and Rick Pitino.
They
both
they are.
Been so emotional tonight.
They are animated, to say the least.
Shot clock under 10. James on the drive, the fadeaway, nope.
Farley's getting tired.
Jenkins, Dean, they're gonna say it. Offensive goaltend. Dean couldn't wait on it.
Farley's playing more, a lot of minutes. It's hot in here. He is racing up on the floor, and he was, you see him dragging the play in the back there. Taquan, of course, as conditioned as anybody, still going strong, but watch. Yeah, it's an easy call. It's
yeah.
The right call.
Not even close. Yeah. Had he waited, might have brought the house down. Marquette's got to collect themselves, trailing by 7.
Novak, there's the screen, there's a ball screen, then he pops to the wing. Oh, they come the other way, though.
Good pass. Fitzgerald, the 3. Oh, in and out. McGee will penetrate, blocking foul on Matthews. And a 1-1 coming up for Andre McGee. And free throw shooting has been an issue for Andre. These are some big free throws.
Cards, as we said, took their first early run. They were at 15-6 at the first media timeout. Marquette cut it to 2. Louisville got another 10-point lead. Marquette actually went ahead by 1, 47-46. Since that point, Louisville has outscored them 10-2, and this fifth run belongs to them. And I guess technically they're still on it, if that had gone in especially.
Minutes to go in this one. That's a carry.
That's a point of emphasis this year. That would have been an advantage gained by the dribbler. That's a good call. That's exactly why they put that rule in. You can't, it's really a discontinued dribble. They call it a carry, but you're basically stopping your dribble and then starting it in another direction, which puts the defense at a ridiculous disadvantage unfairly. And so they made it a point of emphasis this year, and that was the perfect example of it right there. Thumb up is the call. Let's see if the Cards get some movement. They always are more effective when there's movement.
Dean will back it out. Still plenty of time on the shot clock. Splits two defenders. Jake's got to create something. Shot clock at 5. Step back jumper. No.
Got to get back now. The problem is when you force one. Long rebound, guys are leaking out. You got to make sure you don't give up an easy one. Novak's got McGee on a big mismatch, but they don't like to send him down inside. Well, maybe now they are, because Green is telling him to come to Novak's side. But James either didn't hear him or has his own ideas. Yeah, they want to go inside.
Novak is doubled.
Takes a timeout. You know, there was a great coach in the NBA for many years named Red Holtzman who would do that by design. He would give you what appeared to be such a terrible mismatch because he felt that he knew what you were going to do then. You're going to obviously say, hey, we have to throw it there, and then you can form your double teams or get your traps. That's what Louisville did there. McGee was much smaller. When they threw it inside, Palacios knew it was going there, formed the trap, and forced the timeout.
Barbara Walters talks with George Clooney, Patrick Dempsey, Matthew McConaughey, and Mariah Carey for the 25th annual Oscar edition of the Barbara Walters special right after loss tonight on WHAS 11. Notre Dame's lead over Providence is 44-42. got a feeling on your radio show after the game, people are going to be wanting that score because that game started a half hour later than this game did.
So we will obviously be keeping it posted. UConn keeping South Florida at bay, parlayed that 18-0 run to start the game. They lead by 12 right now.
There's the shooting drought for Marquette, but they are hanging around, trail by just 7 points. Still plenty of time. Novak, the fadeaway, that's way off. Dean and Matthews jumping up, possession to the Cards.
Good hustle play. And now we'll get our under 4 minute timeout.
But it has been quite a battle tonight between Louisville and Marquette. 3:57 to go in this one. You do not want to go anywhere. This one's probably going to come down to the wire. Dean trying to win his final game here at Freedom Hall. This one, it's time for the Arby's player of the game.
Well, Brandon Jenkins has brought a lot to the table, notably that they really don't have a traditional low post game, so he's the one that's had to get in the lane, make the defense sink in occasionally. When they do that, it opens up the perimeter. You see the three-point shot there. Again, in the lane, left hand here in the finish. Not only that, he has 7 rebounds in the game, 3 assists for good measure. Pretty good line for Mr. Jenkins. See what they have out of the timeout. Sometimes Rick will draw a special play up out of the timeout.
Matthews has done a nice job on Dean.
Oh, T. Well thought about it. The woman is now lost. He didn't hesitate though. Yikes. That'll be a good pass to Miller.
Still 10 on the shot clock, and Barrow called for the foul. That's team foul number 9. So the 1-1 here, and after that, double bonus time for the Cardinals.
Yeah, that's big. Because certainly the pressure's off. A lot less on the shooter when he knows whether no matter what happens that first one, he's got another one coming.
And Louisville's free throw shooting over the last 3 games has been terrific, and they've really picked it up in that department.
6 of 7 tonight, no complaints there. Louisville has taken 35 three-point shots, just 24 inside the arc.
That free throw no good. Golden Eagles trail by 7, 3.5 to go.
Ken Horn tells us a season high in three-point attempts for the Cards tonight.
Against Tennessee Martin, they threw up 33 threes. And they've eclipsed that tonight.
That's
offensive foul. Novak can't believe it.
I like that call. I watched that whole play develop. Palacios held his ground. Novak battling. Let's watch. Now, maybe the second time it'll have a different look. You see, there's the screen and the roll. It's Jenkins, actually. He's got an elbow right in his neck.
Yeah. That's an easy call.
That is an easy call. That's an obvious call. You know, he sees the mismatch, tries to force it. Jenkins with a small size disadvantage there, but Novak used that hand to ward off. That was, frankly, as you said, pretty easy call, I think.
Palacios.
Well, they need one of those to go down. They have a 10-point lead with under 3 minutes. You got to like your chances. Just haven't been able to get one of them to go. Now they got to get it done at the defensive end. James is going to turn the corner. That's a block. Yep.
That's team foul number 7. So James to the free throw line to shoot the 1-1.
James is not exactly torn it up from the free throw line of the season for a point guard. 65%, not awful for a freshman, but obviously your point guard, you need to be one of the better free throw shooters, ideally.
What Marquette wants, and has only happened once tonight, is to get Novak to the free throw line. Do you realize that he's 72 of 74 this season for the free throw line? That's amazing. If he doesn't suddenly go cold late in the year, he'll have the best free throw percentage in the history of college basketball. But it's James, and he hits the front end of the 1-1.
Well, it's not too early to start thinking about possessions. 3 possession game right now.
Clutch free throws from Dominic James.
Did I say three possession game at 6 points? I hope I didn't. It's a two possession game. My math skills, I really have got to get this calculator fixed. I need to get a nap, I think.
Oh, McGee,
that
the
would
open
make it a
triple.
Three possession game. Yikes.
How do you hit that? And then Palacios.
Oh, that's just sheer force of will. Now it's back to a three possession game. And that is big. Three possessions in 2 minutes. Offensively, if you're just patient, can make the other guy run out of time, even if you don't score every time. What a big follow that was.
Novak, the triple, got it.
Why would you go run at James and leave Novak?
Novak's now got 20 points to lead all scorers.
Oh, Rick is asking Millard, why would you leave him to run at James? Give James that shot with your blessings. Yikes.
There it is.
See the new Big East single season record.
Ray Allen's made a few threes at the next level as well. Steve Novak can only hope to have a career like Ray Allen, but at Novak, it's 6'10". Phenomenal shooter. Great looking stroke, too. Well,
Millard sunk to the lane. That's what he was talking about, but he didn't really run at the shooter, but he sank too far down. You got to stay home on that guy, and now you've got it. I mean, it's technically a two-possession game. Obviously, you can make a three and get fouled, but realistically, a two-possession game.
Patino just kind of looked at Millard with a look that only Coach Patino can give.
He's
making
good.
Sure Millard's got to stay home on Novak.
He's good at those looks. You don't want to get one. Palacios comes and tries to encourage Millard, which is a good thing to do. That is good chemistry on a team. The coach obviously has to have some emotion, and players have to let Millard know, hey, we still got a minute 46 to go here. We need you to play. Speaking of needing to keep playing, UConn's lead has gradually diminished. They started that game 18-0, which is the worst thing you can do against a team without a win in the league. They obviously have let off the gas. That lead is down, I think, under single digits. Might be as low as six right now. Amazingly against South Florida. Keep an eye on that, too. Big possession here. Need a good look. Oh, Taquan's got one.
Taquan will step in. The pass inside. Palacios foul. That's a good foul. Make him earn it at the free throw line.
Got to do that. And what a nice job by Dean. Unselfish.
Goes to Tejo. And obviously free throws right now are at a premium. Palacios is in the mid-60s as well. Not a great free throw shooter, but this will be a pair here. Watch this right here. It sells it. Looks like he's going to shoot that. Nice delivery, and that's a smart foul. I mean, there's nothing dirty about that. Can't concede that.
6 weeks ago, Palacio is not that quick to get off the floor. I mean, he's definitely looking much, much more comfortable in terms of his athleticism.
You got to make some free throws here, though. You can't. You start psychologically playing with your head if every time you go to the line, guys are doing it with a sense of dread. This is a big one. It doesn't do anything in terms of possessions, but it does psychologically. Oops. Ah.
So the lead is just 4 points.
Rick wants him in man here now, not zone. Somebody's wide open. Here comes Tejo.
Somebody better be on Novak. T-Will covering him right now.
T-Will's. Well, they're going to switch it, though, and Dean's got him now.
James, tough shot, no. Dean with the rebound.
That was a good possession. It took about 25 seconds off the clock and gave them nothing.
Dean,
Didn't need that one. Didn't need that one. Don't foul here. Oh, it's
James.
Going in, too.
Basket. They got to wave it off. He was hanging on the rim.
That's okay. That's a good basket. That's right. That's the right call. You're allowed to contact the rim when the ball's in the cylinder.
I just thought he hung on it so long that he then
influenced it. You don't think it's a technical foul. The ball's up in the air, and he goes in. That's nothing. That's legal, folks. Sorry. That's their rule. There's nothing illegal about that. That basket should count. They said it was good. Now they're going to wave it off. If they do, that's wrong.
Officials are talking it over. Tom Crean is getting an explanation.
The only reason this would be waved off is if they think the foul wasn't in the act of shooting, but he is. Well, frankly, I'm not sure it was a foul, to be honest with you, but it went in. That's legal. There's nothing illegal about that. If you are fouled, you can grab the rim to prevent injury. And that ball went in. And he's not touching the rim while the ball is on the rim. It's in the cylinder. They're waving it off, but I'm telling you, it's the wrong call. He let it go. That ball, you're allowed to be on the rim while the ball is in the cylinder. You can't be on the rim while the ball's on the rim. I think they missed that one. Card's got a break.
Some free throws coming up.
The only thing that they may have called is offensive interference, that he grabbed the ball in the cylinder, but I didn't see that. It looked like he caught it outside the cylinder and carried it in.
Free throw is good for James.
It's irrelevant. It's a moot point now. He's on the line. It's one possession game, make or miss here, but Louisville better get the rebound. First things first.
James now has 13 points, 9 rebounds, 5 assists. Just a freshman.
That's long. Look out.
T-Will with the rebound. Jenkins, that's way short. Chance for Marquette to tie with a triple.
They need to be in what we just call one no help. Everybody's man-to-man. You do not help. If a guy wants to shoot a layup, you let him shoot it. Can't give up a three.
3 second difference, game clock to shot clock.
They won't play for one. They'll take the first good one they get.
But they are not going to let Novak get it. I'm telling you.
I think it's a good decision by Coach Green. It didn't look like they were getting into anything. Now he can run a set play and try to get a look for Steve Novak.
Well, if that's what they wanted, I think he didn't call timeout because he would have taken the two. The idea that you foul again, and unless they make both, you could tie or take the lead without even making a three. But when they ran this much time off, I think he felt, hey, we're going to have to get a set and at least build a three-point option in because they've run a little bit too much time off. They ran a good 21 seconds off the clock, as you see 14 on you will see this 14 left on the shot clock.
Claire returns to the scene of her kidnapping with hopes of finding a cure for her baby's mysterious illness. And Jack and Locke keep their prisoners a secret from the other survivors. Stay tuned for Lost immediately following tonight's game, and you will see Lost in its entirety. I agree with you wholeheartedly. I like to see, in that situation, you try to stretch the game. Get a quick two and then force Louisville to shoot free throws.
Well, what you do is if you get a quick two, you could tie or even win without making a three at all. Just work the math out. You score, you're down one. Then if the ball comes in, you can either steal it or foul right away. And if they go to the line and don't make both free throws, a two is either going to get you a tie or the lead. So, but once ran that much time down.
Well, I still think there's enough time to go for a two. You get, shot off by 12 seconds or so.
Tough because Marquette has no timeouts left. So you'd have to cover a lot of ground in the huddle here. I think you could do this. You could run a quick hit for a three, and if it's not there, have an option where you throw it inside, try and get the two, and then tell guys we're in pressure, we foul right away, and then we go a last second, depending on score, if we need a three or a two. You could cover all that in a timeout, but when you got a guy like Novak, I'd be shocked if they don't have some sort of an option to get him a look or one of their other three-point shooters, and they do have some others. Matthews shoots 44% behind the line. So it's not like he's the only shooter they have.
So 17.5 in the game, 14 on the shot clock. Here we go. One Marquette player fell to the ground. James, the three, no. Loose ball, Miller's got it.
They need one. They're not home free yet. They need a free throw.
Double bonus, so Millard will get two free throws.
He's not been at the line yet tonight, though. And before you think this is automatic, put yourself in this situation. You're a freshman. You know that one of the most beloved figures in the program's playing his last game here, possibly. A trip to New York's on the line. This is not an easy free throw to make for Chad Millard. If he makes one or both, he deserves great credit. Don't take it for granted.
You're making me nervous about the free throws.
I just want to let you know it's not an easy thing to do, and you've not shot one yet. He'd be best served to make the first one so he doesn't have the pressure of the second one.
No good. Remember, Marquette, no timeout. So if he misses here, they're just going to have to run it up court and launch a three.
This is where the old adage, if he missed it, do you foul?
What do you think?
I always fouled under five if they dribble the ball up the floor. I don't think Rick will, but if he makes it, it's a moot point.
This is the one for Chad Millard. In and out, loose ball.
That's the right call. He almost came up with an enormous rebound.
Now, Coach Pitino wants a foul. He thought Jenkins got shoved to the floor.
You're not going to get that call in this situation. He knows that.
So 3.9. Oh, he got dragged to the ground by Novak.
He's still not going to get that call in this situation. I mean, that's... He does have a fistful of jersey, but look inside. I mean, his body's flying all over the place. He did yank a fistful of jersey, you're right, but I stand by my statement. More often than not, you're not going to get that call in this league.
3.9 to go.
Due to foul. They are not going to, I don't think. Here comes the heave-ho.
James for the tie. Got it. Wow. Dominic James. An acrobatic three at the buzzer. And we're going to overtime.
Somebody just threw something out of the stands and hit Rick Pitino. Well, Rick's got to watch. He may get a tee. I don't think there's any doubt. It's good. It's on plenty of time. There's no foul. There's nothing much to say. It's just what you see. There's no time to be put on the clock. It's the worst possible combination of events for the Cards.
So Millard misses two free throws with 5 seconds to go in the game that could have sealed it. And Dominic James, well, we talked a lot about this freshman right off the top, the special player. And he hits the triple, and there'll be at least 5 more minutes of basketball here at Freedom Hall.
Well, I mean, you know, let's review it. There's no, I don't know what they're, are they looking at tape? They can't possibly be looking at tape. Reviewing it.
They're still, what the fans are booing about is the takedown by Novak on the rebound.
He had a fistful of jersey. He did. And you can't debate that. But in that situation, in this league, you'll be lucky if you get that call 1 time out of 10. That's just the reality. I've done the games in the Big East for 7 years. I'm telling you, you're just not going to get that. I mean, if you watch that play, guys were beating the snot out of each other the minute the ball left the shooter's hand. That just was the last foul of the bunch. Is he got a fistful of Palacios there? Is another jersey there? Palacios has a fistful of jersey of Fitzpatrick, Fitzgerald. They're all grabbing each other. But he clearly grabbed him at the end. There's no question. And that was the most obvious one. But, you know, if you don't put that out of your mind, this game's going to be over and you're going to wind up just reviewing that call for the rest of the night. I got bad news for you. You got to play the overtime. You got to put it behind you, fellas.
And Coach Pitino is just still furious about the no call on the rebound. Now, Marquette closed the game over the final 6 minutes on a 10-2 run.
Leads to the old Joel's question, though, again. Do you foul in the last situation? 3.9. Rick is still not letting it go. He's got to get back and get his team. They're going to play the overtime. With or without you, Rick.
Yeah, it's been an emotional night from the get-go, senior night.
I've been there. You mean you've coached your brains out. Your kids have left every ounce of their effort on the floor, and you feel like the guy blows the whistle there, the game's over, and he doesn't. It is hard to let it go, but you have no choice. And did he grab jersey? Yes, he did. So before anybody emails me, he did. But the fact of the matter is, I mean, Ari, you've done games in this league for a year. Go back and watch. The shot goes up. I mean, guys are beating each other up. That was the last part of it. It was the most blatant, but the officials are generally not suddenly going to call that a fistful of jersey when they've had the last five go before it. And they did let it go before. All you got to do is go watch.
But as you said, what's done is done. If this Louisville team wants to get to New York, you got to play basketball right
crowd,
now.
The crowd's got to get off the booing because it leads a negative atmosphere. Everybody's focusing on what should have been.
Ball is out of bounds to the Cardinals.
It got ugly for a minute, though. Somebody threw a cup out of the stands, hit Rick.
I'm pretty sure that the intended target was one of the officials, and Rick just walked into the area. No, there's no place for that.
The crowd needs to get the positive energy back, because if you haven't noticed, the game's going on. They're not going to go back and review that and change it. An unfortunate play at the end. But frankly, they could have stopped the three. There's a bunch of things you could have done.
Matthews fouls Taquan Dean.
He's in foul trouble now, Mr. Matthews is. That's 4, I believe. It is.
That is 4 fouls on Wes Matthews.
My friend, who's the coach at Indiana University of Pennsylvania, has a sign in his office, nothing we ever really want is easy. And he reminds himself of that every day, and that's the message right now for the Cards. You want to get to New York, you're going to have to do it the hard way. Could the game be over? Absolutely, but
You know, there's still play that has to, plays have to be made here in the last 4:44.
This rivalry is pretty special. There have been so many great games between these two teams, and certainly put this one near the top of the list.
You know, I have to speak in defense of the officials, and this will get me hate mail, but I have to say it. Don't you hear fans all the time say, oh, I hate when the officials decide the game. Well, that's when you don't let them make calls late and decide the game. That's what happens. So you can't have it both ways. That's a rebound. Everything was fair game. Guys were beating each other up. Somehow you got to find a way to get that basketball or stop the three. They didn't either, and so you're in overtime.
Matthews inside. Reverse layup is good for Wes Matthews. Game tied again.
Although this will be one of the most painful losses if the Cards don't wind up getting it. They've got to get down to business here. There's no other way to look at it. That's the reality.
Dean off the screen. Squares up and drills the three. Taquan Dean.
How's that for guts? Kid was 2 of 13 shooting threes until that one. Knocks down a three and makes it a three-point game in overtime. That's big.
You always talk about how he lands when he takes off on the shot. That time he really squared himself up to the basket and knocked it down.
Shot at a half a count slower. You're right. Got himself in good balance.
James, 16 points, 10 rebounds, and 6 assists. Shot clock down to 5. What's he going to do?
Great defense. That's great defense. That was terrific late shot clock defense. It's amazing how sometimes guys get paralyzed late in the shot clock because they don't want to bail you out with a foul. They don't want to make a mistake. That time they stayed aggressive, locked the two bodies at the top of the defense, didn't allow a split, turned it into a turnover. And this would be an enormous possession offensively.
3:20 to go in overtime.
I don't know why. Something tells me Dean is going to shoot it again. I've been wrong before. Let's see. Oh, big score there. Notre Dame, 2-point lead. Let's see if Taquan gets another look. He's going down, and then he's going to come off the screen. Here he comes. There he is.
Dean will drive it. He slips. 5-on-4. Dean behind the play right now. McNeil, nice hesitation. Miller,
great challenge
block.
By Miller. Yep. Didn't block it, but challenged it.
Two and a half to go in overtime.
They look for a driving kick to Taquan. Oh, you just throw it both. Kick it to Palacios.
Palacios can't finish.
Boy, they are going to make this as hard for themselves as they can, it appears. It's one of those nights. The question is, do they have the last play in them? It's hot. People are tired, and the pressure is palpable in this building right now.
It's also a ton of fun watching these two teams battle this hard. That's blocked by T. Will.
That's a big-time block there. You can't let him dodge three bullets. Somebody's got to get a bucket this time down the floor. They need a bucket badly to give themselves a little room for a mistake. You can't play perfectly down the end of the game.
T. Will. Miller doesn't want the jumper. Still plenty of time on the shot clock.
Well, they are on Dean like Louisville's on Novak, way out high.
Dean, floater, no.
Got it back.
Taps it out. Dean's triple, that's way off.
They are making it as hard as they can. It's one of those nights. Sometimes you do believe in fate. The question is, will they have the last play in them in a dramatic win?
The search for that elusive sixth win in the Big East Conference for the Cardinals tonight. Matthews to tie it. No.
Run. Don't go. Oh, I don't know. Rick wants him to slow it up. Yeah, under a minute. That's a good decision. I was going to say run. You might get a cheap one. Then it's two possessions, and the thing is almost done. Boy, these guys are starting to get tired now. You see it in their faces, the effort that's been exerted here. That's going to be the same situation, though. Louisville, if they run the shot clock all the way down, if they don't score, they're going to be nursing a three-point lead with the last possession of the game.
Do you think if that's the same situation that Pitino would consider fouling, or is he a coach who just that does not what he does?
I think most guys have a philosophy, and they you know, do what they do, and so I don't think that he will foul, no.
It is time for the DQ difference of the game, and this will be a highlight that will be talked about for a long time. Novak takes down Jenkins, no call. And that led to the three-pointer at the buzzer for Dominic James, and that's the reason why we're still playing basketball.
There's the shot that tied it. I mean, you know, lost and all that, that's a pretty damn good shot.
That's a heck of a shot by James. Now, tonight, Louisville has set a new school record with three-point attempts. Well, no, the school record is 40, and tonight they've shot 39.
Well, if all goes well for Rick Pitino, that record will be intact, because the last thing he's going to want is a three. Unless they run the shot clock down here and drive and a kick, they might tie it. But if they have to take two threes left with these last 37 seconds, it means something's gone wrong. They want nothing but a whatever the shot of choice is on this possession and free throws the rest of the night. That would be a perfect last 37 seconds for the Cards.
To say there hasn't been much scoring in overtime would be an understatement. Louisville's outscored them 5-2 in the extra session.
Well, that guy you just saw on the poster is the guy who got the big three. Taquan Dean with the big three that has provided the margin right now. I imagine if you're Marquette, you've gone this far, you're not going to foul. If you were going to foul, you would have fouled already. So they're willing to take a chance. If Louisville runs it all the way down, they'll get the ball back with 22 seconds to go. But again, the danger behind doing that is if Louisville scores here, Marquette's almost out of time.
15 left on the shot clock. See the timeouts left.
That's where they wanted it. That's where they got it. He's going to try and create something.
Dean trying to put the Eagles away, and it's a blocking foul. And Dean will go to the free throw line. Foul on Chapman.
Dicey. Here we go again. Let's watch. Here's the cross. Yeah, it's a good call.
Yeah, very good call.
Well, that's the guy they wanted at the line.
Yep. The lead is 4.
Well, now if you're Marquette, you're clearly going to score as quickly as you can. I would think they'll put it in James' hands, and his task will be to take it right to the rack. Louisville shouldn't get too passive, because with a 5-point lead, you can be aggressive, and if you stop them here, the game is over.
Dean has scored all 7 of U of L's points in overtime.
And they're looking for a 3. I'm surprised at that. Oh, I think this is playing right into Louisville's hands.
Now, Tom Crean wants a timeout.
That was not what they wanted. They're going to leave themselves not enough time. 17 seconds. Even if they make a 3, it's going to be awfully tough.
Keep in mind, everyone, Lost coming up right after the game. It will be seen in its entirety. They'll all be sitting out there loving the basketball, but knowing Lost is coming up, you won't miss a second of it.
I hope no Louisville fan just clicked the TV on, saw that at the bottom, and said, oh my goodness, look at that. Louisville, they put in big letters at the bottom there. They lost. That's not it. It's a hit series.
And after Lost, the Barbara Walters Oscar edition special.
Yeah. And there she is. There's lots of big names on that show.
She doesn't have a real hard time getting people to come on her show.
She gets the impossible get, as they say. The impossible get appeared like this might be the trip to New York for the Cards, but they're on the cusp right now. Oh, the Cards cannot get a break in any way, shape, or form. You know what? If they get to New York, it should be, they should make them get off the bus and walk the last half mile, just symbolically, so they
know it's a grind.
Struggle to get there.
It has been a grind.
That's what they wanted to begin with.
The kick out, Fitzgerald's 3, no. Ball is loose, here's T-Will. Showtime!
I think it's finally done.
What an exclamation point!
Ralph Willard just let loose an exhale on the bench. I think I felt all the way over here. Kevin Willard, rather. Not his father, obviously. With good reason. This was a hard-earned win, and it's finally over.
There it is! Louisville wins 67-60. Taquan Dean kisses the floor. His final home game. What a game, what a game. Taquan Dean, 7 points in overtime, finishes with 19 points.
Tom Crean gives him a big handshake. Classy gesture by Taquan and Tom Crean.
And this guy knows how to finish a basketball game. T. Will throws it down.
Symbolic, I guess, if that's the guy, as Robbie Valentine alluded to, that the torch is being passed to. Taquan had the most important points in the overtime, and this guy had the exclamation point to finally mark what makes a good opportunity for a trip to New York for the Cards.
Fans were frustrated, but the extra 5 minutes of basketball was amazing. Louisville gets the win, their sixth win in conference play. We'll be right back. An amazing season for us at WHAS. So much thanks to everyone in the truck. On behalf of my partner Bob Albano and Robbie Valentine, I'm Ari Wolf saying so long from Freedom Hall. Take care, everybody. I love y'all.